69 of them.
69 pipes for 3 copper spoons for €12. They cost me not.
Jesus Christ.
The trace, the tip of the trace from putting on the line was fucking more bringing in the pipe.
You caught that many with the 1 copper spill, did
with
you?
With the 3 copper spoons. 3 the same copper spoons. But there were only €12. There was 69 pipe caught in the 3 same copper spoons.
Jeez.
And the fucking, the tip of the trace was more. What's That's the, why I used the cut you.
What's the biggest trout you ever got?
Trout?
Yeah.
8 or 10 pound.
8 or 10 pound, was it?
When I met one with a weight tied on, reeling her slowly. I took two 8 pounders out, but between 8 and 10. I had to.
Around here, was it?
Up the river. Mm. Do you know why you had to take them? The MEPs went down through them, I couldn't get out of them. Couldn't fucking get out of them. I caught one the far side there, 4 or 5 years ago, when a young lad standing on the boat with me, he'd be 12 now. So he was only about 5 at the time. And I was standing on that boat, you see the timber the far side?
Yeah.
He went up over the timber lad and I couldn't stop him from going over the weir. And do you know what I had under a 2-piece steel rod?
Yeah.
70 pound sea line. Jeez. Couldn't hold him.
Couldn't hold him.
Couldn't fucking hold him.
What was that pike, was it?
Trout.
Trout.
I came down here another winter time and I was fishing in the winter time. See the third boat out?
Yeah.
The trout took off then, boy. And he came along, lad, and he went over the iron bar. And see the stone part? Never touched the iron bar or the stone part of me standing up on it.
Straight over.
And a cousin of mine walking under the bridge, he says to me, "What's that?" So I go round the far side and you'd see. Jesus, you're turning the boat on you, lad.
Okay.
Oh, it'd be an awful job to keep you. What net to bring in that?
Wow.
They broke 3 reeds on me, the trout, I was getting them that big.
Yeah?
Broke 3 fucking reeds. They wouldn't be real strong ones, but I didn't give a shite, I'd fucking replace them again, anyway. I went up 2 years ago. Well, it'd be 3 years ago now, right? In 7 days. Got 12 trout, over 4 pound, are you listening to me?
Yeah.
In 7 days. Went up the next day for an hour and a half, right? Came back in an hour and a half and 2 more. 14 trout.
14?
In 8 days. Over 4 pound. And I took off every one of the trout and I flipped them straight back into it.
Go fuck a man yourself.
14 of them. And there was a boy going up from the north one time and me had to catch him one. Who was just slaying that? That's why they'd be renting the caravans anyway. Yeah. Give someone else a chance to catch one. Fuck them. There's more than them fishing. There's people driving from Dublin and fucking Cork and everywhere the fishing.
You can rent them caravans, eh?
Huh?
You can rent
they're
them.
They're their own. They're only renting the field, you see.
Ah, yeah.
They're their own, eh? But you see, he come along and he says to me, he says, he come over to me and he says, "Give me that." And I says, "No. Lovely trout, but just gone for." He was standing there and he was in front of me. He says, "I wouldn't go up there." He says, "I can't go out, I have no license." I said nothing anyway. Just saying by, and then I was walking through the trees in a couple of days after, looked out, saying by was at the head of the boat. Say, "Where's the license now?" Well, me not giving a fuck. If I wanted the trout, I'd catch it anyway. But I took the trout and he looking at me and led straight back and he says, "He'd be there for somebody else." Say, "You catch him." Oh, he was fucking raging that he was leaping on the line. He said, "You catch him." Oh, it broke his heart though. Another foreigner come up that and he was looking for dead bait for the pike, you see, and yeah, to tell you they didn't understand.
Look at it.
And he says to me, he pulled up and he says to me, "You give me that, you know, the perch."
Yeah.
And I wouldn't give it to him to kill the pike. So he went off anyway. He was out there saying, "You get known." He pulled up a little bit and I could hear him saying to your man the far side, "Bastard." I just stood back to say, "You know what you'll do? Fuck off, you and him." And, oh, he could understand that. Because I wouldn't give him the dead bait to kill the bike. He knew fucking well. Oh, he knew well, though. Oh, I knew well what he was saying, and he knew too. I fucked them over, but they're dangerous to hooers. They'd lift a boat or they'd lift anything. Like, you can't trust the cunts. They're not right in the head. They'll do anything to get fish.
Pull out a fucking knife and stick in it. They pull out a knife and stick in it.
They're not right in the head. Sure, lad, fish it if he wants to fish it.
Yeah.
Huh? I got fucking thrown up the river, lad, and they nearly landed me a dinner.
Yeah?
Off the bank, yeah. They'd take you. They'd take you that height. I went up with another cousin. He's going to school in the tech now. He's 13. I had the sea line on it too, and I had the 2-piece steel rod, and I told him not to let go. I took up the trout anyway, and I knew it was trout. He let it go, lad. And I was above, standing inside the electric fence. Well, he lifted him that much off the ground. All I could see was the feet going and the legs going. I had to grab him like this or he was in the fucking middle of it. But the trout buried it under the tree. And me trying to hold there, man. Jesus Christ, that fuck. I wouldn't mind, but I had it in. He says, give me right. I'd like to have a bit of fun with that. So you won't have a bit of fun with that. There's an awful serious way on the end of it. So there's a big throw on the end of it. Jeez, yeah. He let it out a bit that. He was gone like a cunt. I seen another lad nearly drowned it up the corner one time. They were using the worm, you see. It's a worm, William. And I was this side, the high side. I went down at the back of the house. Walked across the fields in the winter. And be Jesus, anyway. There's a lad round the corner and you can't see round it. And he says, I have him. So I thought the lad run round to see what he had. But be Jesus, he pulled the trout too quick, but the trout landed in him in the fucking middle of it. He was roaring in 2 minutes for a man to throw out the rod, and all I could see was his head. Well, I went home and I busted me bollocks for half an hour. Now I had the time, like, but he was fucking bobbing 16 foot of water, and he was going down and down, and he roared and put the rod. I couldn't stop fucking laughing at it. Oh, Jesus Christ, come on, mate. Honest to Jesus, straight down into it. Throw me out the rod quick, said he. Says. See, he put out the worm. See, when we stand on the house side, I could see the trout grabbing the worm.
Yeah.
But when the trout grabbed it, your man says, I have one. And he tried to bring it in too quick. It was 12 or 14 pounds. You'd have to leave it there a fucking hour. Huh?
What madness, isn't it?
Oh, Jesus Christ. Ah, oh, but they're not right in the head what to do. But Jesus, I tell you what, if that lad happened to be along with him, where was he?
Yeah, gone.
Gone. Fucking throw it out to be worth that. Gone, and I buried him. I laughed at that, though. Jesus, you wouldn't laugh at it at the time, though. All you could see was that. And he rolling at your man to give him the rod. There's an awful power in a fucking throat. Even an 8-pounder, isn't there?
Yeah, there is. Pull your fucking in.
Oh, Jesus, he'd bury. Oh, no fucking well he would. Oh, Jesus. Fucking bury you. You know, I love the power of them. I wouldn't give a shit what to break me. I love catching it. They tell you there's none there. There is trout there.
Oh, there is, eh?
And there's big trout on the lake as well. Should have put them up there. Should they go out there and they tell you they wouldn't go up on no license? Should they have none? Should they trawl net and everything? They're using and passes and they're ripping the shay out of the boats and everything to get them.
Yeah.
Get whatever they can. One fella there, I know him there, he used to fish the fisheries as well. And he said to me, Anton, lately, but he'd know I'd be putting them back anyway. I wouldn't give a shit. If I wanted to bring a big trout, they'd never see me bringing them anyway. I could come home away that nobody'd ever see anyway. I'd catch him anyway. But he goes out now fly fishing. And you know what he said? It was gone that bad.
Huh?
And that's all he does now. He says, I'll go out and I'll get one now myself. He says, before they're all gone. Yeah. He does the fly fishing. They know if they're in it or not.
Yeah.
Oh, it was a dread. Oh, Jesus, it was a dread 10 years ago. I wouldn't come home without a trout down there, up there 10 years ago. On a spinner now.
Uh-huh.
I wouldn't come home without a trout. Wouldn't. I got a small one there. It'd be 2 or 3 weeks ago, but it just wasn't fucking 2 pounds. A cousin of mine got one there 3 or 4 weeks ago. 4. That's not a bad throw.
That's all right, isn't it? £4.
£4, yeah. Sure, £3 trout is a nice throw.
Only for fucking pound and £2 it though.
Huh?
£2 trout is a nice throw.
Would you like him?
Ah, yeah.
And give you fucking 50 cents for him, mate. I'd love it. Even if one broke the rod and the reed, I'd love to catch him, but I wouldn't give you 50 cents to hit him. I don't like the hook.
No.
But big perch is nice.
Yeah, big perch. Fry it up and put a bit of salt on it.
Uh-huh. Trout is nice, but... Oh, dear.
I better go and see if I can catch up myself.
I took, with spinners, I took 994 fish.